Assalamualaikum and good day everyone. Today we will proceed. Okay, we are at week 3, so we're going to proceed with chapter 1, stress, strain and modulus of elasticity relationships. Last week we are done with stress, so this week we will go to the strain and modulus of elasticity relationship. Okay, first we look at what is strain. So by definition, when loads of any type are applied to a body, the body will undergo dimension changes. This is called deformation. Tensile and compressive stresses causes changes in length, torsional shearing stress. Stresses causes twisting and bearing stresses cause indentation in the bearing surface. So this is what the deformation on types of stresses that being applied to a body. Yeah? Okay, the measure of this change in shape is called strain. Okay, maksudnya deformation yang kita panggil strain. Because before, as what we learn, when a force applied to any object, so the object try to maintain the shape. So when it try to maintain its shape, so that object is in state of stress. Okay, so strain ni pula adalah the measures of the deformation ataupun change of the shape of the object. Yeah. The formula for strain is increase in length ataupun decrease in length lah, maksudnya perbezaan length, divide by the original length. Or you can use this formula which is strain, this is the symbol, divide by delta, which is change in length, divide by the original length. Or maybe kalau you boleh pakai this delta ataupun ini pun sama, segitiga ni length, maksudnya difference in length divide by delta, it's just the same thing. Okay, depends on type of force that you put on the object. Okay, if this one, this is a tensile force, so dia objek ni tertarik lah, so dia akan elongate. While okay, this one salah ni, bukan elongation, this is like the compress. Okay, while the other one, if you put like compressive force, so dia akan compress lah, penyit lah, maksudnya shorten. Unit of strain, by definition, strain is the ratio of the change in dimension to the original dimension value. For example, length divided by length, area divided by area, volume divided by volume. So consequently, strain is dimensionless quantity and has no units. Because if let's say, delta, you kira kan? Okay, delta ni perhaps like in millimeter. So, yelah mungkin 2 mm lah, the difference in length. 2 mm, and then you divide with the total length, which is perhaps 2000 mm. So you divide, it will cancel out this mm, so it is dimensionless. So strain has no dimension. And then elasticity, we look at what is elasticity. All material bodies will deform when placed in state of stress, and as the stresses increase, the deformation also increases. Jadi bila, because of kita tahu stress is force divided by area, it's a force, so whether it's pulling out ataupun it's pushing in. Okay, so it can be either tu lah. Okay, and then bila stress ni naik ataupun bila force naik, maksudnya deformation akan also increase. In some cases, when the load causing the deformation are removed, the body returns to its original shape. And a material or body having this property is said to be elastic. Okay, jadi any object yang boleh return to the original shape, kita panggil dia elastic. If the stress is steadily increased, sooner or later after the removal of the load, not all the induced strain is recovered. This is called elastic limit. So if let's say, kalau katakan you ada column macam ni, column juga saya cerita. Atau okay, for example, senang cerita contohnya rubber band. When you pulling it out. Okay, you tarik dia. Okay, at some point. Okay, mula-mula okay, kalau you tarik dia sikit, mungkin bila you lepas dia, dia go back to the original shape, which is bulat tu lah. Okay, but sooner when you tarik lebih-lebih, you tarik exceeding dia punya limit. Okay, jadi dia akan mungkin ada sesetengah bukan, dia mungkin akan panjang sikit daripada original dia. Okay, mungkin dia punya diameter ni perhaps it is 10 mm. Okay, so masa ni dia elastic lah, you tarik sikit, you letak stress sikit kan, you tarik dia, okay, it can go back to the 10 mm diameter. But later perhaps you tarik lagi, you tarik, you pulling it out. Okay, when it reach the elastic limit, when you release it, it will lose dia punya some of the elasticity. Maksudnya strain tu, not all the induced strain is recovered. Maksudnya dia tak boleh balik pada original shape, but, tapi dia still masih elastic lah. Maksudnya dia still lagi mungkin dia punya diameter akan jadi 12 contohnya lah, tambah 2 mm, like that lah. So dia dah sampai, dia dah reach the elastic limit. Within the elastic range, strain is proportional to the stress causing it. This is called the modulus of elasticity. The I believe that maybe if any of you mungkin ada ambil, I'm not sure whether in science you learn it or not, but if let's say in physics, you will definitely pernah dengar Hooke law ni. The greatest stress of this strain is still proportional, is called the limit of proportionality. Okay, meaning bila you tarik band tadi contohnya 10 mm, okay, when you release it, dia masih lagi 10 mm. Maksud dia, dia masih lagi proportional eh, because dia boleh go back to the original shape. Okay, tapi when you release it, dia dah 12 mm. Maksudnya dia dah tak, dia dah tak elastic. Maksudnya dia dah tak proportion. A convenient way of demonstrating elastic behavior is to plot graph of the result of simple tensile test carried out on a thin mild steel rod. The rod is hung vertically and series of forces are applied at the lower end. Two gauge points are marked on the rod and distance between them is measured after each force increment has been added. The test is continued until the rod breaks. Okay. So I tunjuk terus. Contohnya lah, this is
this is terminology. And if we apply a force to a spring and it gets longer, then we
should
talk about a tensile force. So something which is in tension is something that's basically being pulled. But sometimes we have a spring which we can then compress. And if we have a compressive force or compression, that's when the force is acting inwards. And it tends to be that things in tension get longer, things in compression get shorter. So here I have my retort stand, my boss, and my clamp. And what I'm going to use is just the rod end of this. Now, if I take my spring, what I can do is I can measure the original length of the spring. Now, as I add more and more masses using a mass hanger with a load of 100 gram masses on, as I put this on here, what we find is that the spring extends. Now, when I add more and more masses, it's fairly obvious, but the spring gets longer. You know, you don't need to be doing A-level physics to work that out. And what we can look at is the change in the length of the spring, the difference between the original length and then how much it's actually extended. And we call this extra length the extension. Because we like to quantify things in physics, what we can look at is how much force that we apply, or effectively the weight that we're adding, and also how that affects the extension. And I'm going to use the symbol X for extension. And what we find is, as you apply a bigger force, the extension gets longer. And we actually get a fairly nice region like this, where the force is proportional to the extension. And we can therefore say that F is equal to Kx. And this is all put together nicely in Hooke's law. So what Hooke's law states is that the extension is proportional to the force applied, provided that the limit of proportionality is not exceeded. But really what we can see here is that the force is equal to Kx, where K is what we call the spring constant. So So this spring constant tells us how much a spring or a piece of material will extend when a certain force is applied. And what we find is that we have different sorts of springs. This one here might be quite stiff compared to this one here, which is fairly lazy. And different springs have their own spring constants. So it might be that you apply the same force and we get a different extension. The important thing to note is on this graph here, the gradient is equal to the change in force divided by the change in extension, so effectively F over X. And that means the gradient is equal to the spring constants. So this one here, the blue one, might be this spring here that's very stiff. The spring that we have over here might be more like the green line that we have over here.
So I hope you understand on that. Thus, if a graph is drawn, a stress against strain, so sama je macam mana graph yang dia tunjukkan tadi sebab dia buat like stress. And then tadi dia tanda like X ya. Tapi X ni kalau kita tandakan dia difference in length ya. So kita tak pakai X as what the video shown. We going to use strain eh. Here. Okay. Thus if a graph is drawn of strain against strain, stress against strain as the load is gradually applied, the first portion of the graph will be a straight line. So macam yang ditunjuk tadilah. So ini nama dia limit of proportionality. So sampai limit of proportionality. Maksudnya dia proportion je, sama saja, dia constant eh. When you keep on adding load to the spring, contohnya macam tadi, macam that example in the video. So strain ni pun, meaning change in length pun akan keep on increasing lah. Okay, sama, constant. The slope of this graph line is the constant of proportionality. Modulus of elasticity or Young modulus should be considered as the measure of the stiffness of the material. This is the graph. So yang you nampak tadi yang dia lukis, so inilah graph dia, elastic. Okay, elastic. Sampai limit of proportionality, meaning that maksudnya strain is proportion to the strain. Okay, jadi dia sama. You reach the elastic limit. So elastic limit, sampai elastic limit, they lose a little bit of the elasticity dekat situ. Okay, maksudnya dia dah tak proportion, but dia masih lagi elastic sampai this elastic limit, because dia dah lose. Mungkin yang macam I bagi tahu tadi, like rubber band, if you tarik dia melebihi limit of proportionality, contohnya dia takkan dapat get back to the 10mm diameter lagi. Okay, mungkin dia akan jadi 12mm. Okay, sampai this elastic limit. Alright, and then you will reach the plastic. Okay, so plastic ni is actually getah you dah loose. Okay, is loose, dia dah loose, dia dah kembang. Maksudnya dia dah memang lost dia punya elasticity characteristics, and then dia adalah plastik because dia dah memang kembang, dia dah lost every dia dah tak boleh lagi nak you nak bend dia, dia tak nak balik ke asal lagi eh. And then plastik at one point you akan reach dia punya ultimate. Okay, when you keep on adding, dia akan reach ultimate and later on dia akan break, so getah you putus. So ini sama je if let's say you apply to the, contohnya like the video, they apply to spring or maybe the one that I explained earlier dalam slide ni, yang mungkin dia pakai rod, like rod besi tu kan, they keep on adding load at the end of the rod. Okay, so they keep on adding load there, perhaps lama-lama dia akan panjang. Eh, lama-lama dia akan putus. Bukan putus, patah. So, masa ni dia fail lah. The relationship between stress and strain is found to be constant in elastic materials. Okay, dia constant. According to Hooke's law, strain is proportional to the stress causing it, providing that the limit of proportionality has not been exceeded. Okay, jadi sampai limit of proportionality sahaja. After that, mungkin dia akan lose dia punya a little bit of the elasticity eh. Here by the Hooke law, the experiment, we can see that strain is strain is proportional to the strain, and it is constant. Okay, constant. So maksudnya sekarang constant ni adalah modulus of elasticity. Okay, contohnya kalau macam dalam video tadi dia tunjuk macam gambar R, something like that. But we going to use E, eh. E as the symbol for modulus of elasticity. Dia bukan ini. Ini adalah strain. Okay. But E here is modulus of elasticity. Okay. Ini adalah macam orang panggil apa, eh? Constant tadi, eh. Constant yang the macam dalam eksperimen tadi, spring tu punya constant. Sama juga macam rod punya constant. So sebenarnya dia depends pada materials apa yang you pakai. Different materials have a different constant ataupun modulus of elasticity. Same goes with the spring that been shown in the video. Because of different spring types. Sebab tadi dia ada tunjuk like a few graph yang perhaps one is like this and the other one is like this. The other one is like this. The more stiff the spring is, or maybe tebal lagi, the thickness of the spring tu lebih tebal or whatsoever. Jadi dia punya modulus of elasticity dia berbeza. Different materials have a different modulus of elasticity. Dalam this formula, ini sebenarnya daripada yang constant tadilah. Macam mana dia dapatkan the end formula is this one, eh. So I tak nak explain lah. This one you boleh tengok sendiri how they create this formula delta ataupun difference in size, different in length, sama je. Different in length equal to FL divide by AE. Okay, F here means force, L means original length, A is area of cross section, and E is Young modulus of elasticity. This thing only applies to the, maksudnya you hanya boleh pakai this formula masa dia dekat limit of proportionality tadi. Sampai sini tadi contohnya, okay, lepas tu dia naik sikit, lepas tu dia macam herot sikit, lepas tu dia loose, kan. Sampai limit of proportionality ni saja you boleh pakai this formula. Okay, sebab dia constant masa sampai limit of proportionality saja. So first, we look at example 11 sebab kita dah finish example 10 last kali bila kita belajar stress last week. Determine the strength in length of the steel tie rod 3 meter long and 30 mm diameter when subjected to tensile load of 120 kN. So how are we going to do this? As usual, kalau you rasa you tak pasti, terus keluarkan dulu formula D equal to FL divide by AE. Bila you nampak perkataan increase in length, okay, maybe some of you might get confused whether what the question actually want you to find. Okay, you tengok apa yang dia ada. Dia minta delta, increase in length. Okay, and given here, steel rod 3 meter long. So this is original length. And 30 mm diameter. So this must be what is it, diameter, which you boleh dapatkan area when subjected to a tensile load of 120 kN. When you look at the formula that you have here, okay, you can check what actually given. You dah ada force, you dah ada length, and you dah ada, you boleh dapatkan area. And given also modulus of elasticity 210. It is there already. So you nak dapatkan increase in length. So whenever before you answer any question, okay, you must look at what actually given to you in order for you to answer the question, eh. Kita nak makan formula ni. F obviously memang dah ada. Length obviously dah ada. The only thing that we need to calculate is the area. So you can use this formula ataupun you boleh pakai pi r square. Without any doubt, you will get the same value. I dapat 706.858. And you just calculate the delta. Just fill in whatever here. Okay. And notice here, I tak tukar this 120 kN to Newton when I'm using this formula. Why? Okay, because you actually boleh bukan delete, boleh cancel out this kilonewton with this kilonewton because of the modulus of elasticity is in kilonewton. Okay, jadi you boleh je terus 120 kilonewton remain like that times 3000. Okay, 3000 here because of 3 meter, you kena tukar dia into millimeter. Why? Because you notice here this is in millimeter. So if you have any equation, just make sure that you convert all the units into the same. No, all units must be the same. Okay, sebab one kat sini dah millimeter, you tak nak menyusahkan diri tukar on the modulus of elasticity part. The cara paling senang you nak kira, you tukar dekat dia punya length. So here you boleh terus cancel out dekat sini. And then kilonewton, kilonewton hilang, millimeter, millimeter pun hilang, then you get 2.425. Okay, and whoever that use calculator hitam just make sure that you letak ini dalam kurungan before you bahagikan because of, if not, you takkan bahagi semua. Mungkin you bagi 706.858 and then you darab to 10. You tak bahagikan dia actually. Don't forget to put the bracket there. And then we go to example 12. A timber specimen of 5mm square cross section was initially 200mm long parallel to the grain. After an axial compressive load of 40 kilonewton was applied, the specimen shortened by 0.29 mm. Determine the longitudinal elastic modulus of the timber. Okay, on this question, it asks you to find the elastic modulus, which is E. And here, it gives you the 5mm square. So, 5mm square here, it means that this is 50mm and this is 50mm. So, you boleh dapatkan dia punya area. Okay. Was initially 200mm long. So, this one is L. Okay. After the axial load compressive load of 40 kilonewton. So, this is force. So, obviously F, L, A, E, you ada benda tu. Okay, and then 0.29 here, this is delta ataupun difference in length. So, you have all of it. You boleh kira lah. But here, dia nak minta E Dia bukan minta F, dia bukan minta delta. Okay, so you have this formula delta equal to FL divide by AE. Okay. Jadi kita boleh pakai this formula, but as usual you need to calculate the area. So 50mm times 50mm you get 2500mm square. And then you have this formula. Okay. Here I tak tukar like because you need to find E kan. Mungkin you boleh tulis macam ni lah to avoid yourself getting confused. Okay. So, because E dah pergi sini, so delta akan turun bawah. So, you just do like this. You will get the value of E. Okay. So, here, I dapat sama kan, like 40 kilonewton is F. Okay, ini adalah F. And 200 is L. 2500 is A. And 0.9 is delta. Sama macam yang I tulis dekat sini. You will get the value, which is 11.034 kilonewton per millimeter square because of this is the form apa units yang biasa kita pakai for modulus of elasticity, kilonewton per millimeter square. Next we go to example 13. Okay, a mass concrete pier, okay, here it have pier again, of rectangular cross section 600mm times 800mm and 2.2 long carries an axial compressive load of 2500. Okay, so here you have pier. Okay, yang size dia is maybe 800 like this and 600 like this and 2.2 meter. Okay, this one in millimeter. Of 2,500, at top here you have 2,500 kilonewton that being transferred to the pier. Determine the stress in the concrete at the base of the pier. So it has asked you untuk kira stress dekat bawah ni. So this is the combination of question of yang the first one yang kita belajar stress, and the second one which is the shortening ataupun the strain or modulus of elasticity. First kita kira stress dulu. So stress, as usual, you dah familiar with the formula, force divide by area. This is the formula yang you biasa pakai. However, our force here bukan 2500 only, because as you see, the question asked to find the stress and in the concrete at the base of the pier. Therefore, you need to find the stress at the base of the pier. Okay. In order to do so, you need to find the unit weight of the pier. Okay. Given kat sini juga, so the density of concrete is 2,500 kilogram per meter cube. Jadi dia bagi density. So as usual, what you need to do is we need to find the volume. So 600 mm convert into meter and 800 mm convert into meter and times with the 2.2 meter height. You akan dapat the volume. And then we can simply kira. Kalau you nak asingkan, you boleh asingkan, kira dulu volume dia asing and then masuk dalam this formula. But this one consider M lah. Okay, and this one is G. Okay, mass. Kenapa dia jadi mass? Because bila you darabkan, because you know that as what I've been telling you before, 1 meter cube is equal to 2,500 kilo gram for the concrete pier. Dia punya density, kita dah tahu 1 meter cube concrete untuk pier ni, dia punya mass dia adalah 2500. Okay, tapi sekarang the area bukan 1 meter cube, it is 1.056 meter cube. Okay, jadi meter cube boleh cancel out, so you will get in kilogram. Maksudnya you dapat mass lah. And then we going to times with the gravity acceleration, which is 9.81. And you will get 25,894.4 newton. Okay. So this is in newton. Ataupun if let's say you convert into kilonewton, you bagi 1000, you akan dapat 25.898 kilonewton. Campur kan? Because you must also include the force that coming from the above, which is 2500 tadi. Okay, macam yang saya lukis ni lah. Okay, you nampak 2500, so you kena masuk campurkan juga, sebab force tu pun ada force dari atas, you kena add together with the self weight of the pier, then you will get this value. Okay, and then we going to calculate the area. So kat sini, okay, you nampak kat sini, kenapa I tukar dia kilonewton, because I kena campurkan this 2500 dalam kilonewton juga. Kalau you dah tukar, kalau katakan kat sini you pakai newton, this kilonewton kat sini 2500 ni, please convert into newton lah. Darab 1000 lagi ya. That's why kat sini I tukar dia kilonewton, so senang I tambah lah. And then kira juga area, because we going to divide it with the area. Simple saja. So after that you masukkanlah the value of the force, the total force, and divide with the area of the cross section of the pier, because of pier tu macam ni at the bottom here, then at the bottom, so you tambah these two forces, self weight and force above, and the cross section at the bottom in this one is sama juga, which is 800 by 600 ataupun 600 by 800, sama je. You dapatlah value dia, which is the stress. And then we going to answer the second question. The second question asks you to find the amount of shortening that will occur in the peer. Okay, so dia minta you cari delta, and given also the modulus of elasticity, which is 13 kilonewton per millimeter square. Shortening kan, jadi kita pun bolehlah pakai formula delta equal to FL divide by AE. Okay, masukkan saja. Okay, but you notice here this 2500, you takkan pakai value 2525 here. Why? Because this one dia minta shortening that will occur in the peer. Maksudnya shorten in the peer, the self weight of the peer itself does not affecting, does not will not be include as the load yang cause the shortening. Because of, biasalah kan kalau kita tengok load daripada atas like this, it should be whatever that come above yang shorten the pier, bukannya the load itself of the pier, dia takkan shorten kan this pier. Okay, therefore this is 2500 because of the load that coming from above. And then 2200, this one is the actual per height of the pier, which is 2.2 meter tadi, kita convert into millimeter. Ingat because of kita punya modulus of elasticity kat sini dalam kilonewton per millimeter square. So kita nak cancelkan dia. Okay. A, actually kita dah ada here. Just put it this value. The area, the cross-section area ni. Okay, cross-section area peer you. Okay, jadi you darabkan then you will get value lah. Okay, so the value is 0.881 millimeter. Okay, then we are done with this example. So next we look at example number 14. So for example number 14, okay, dia buat combination again. One is for stress, so determine stress. So when it asks for stress, so you know that the mesti minta sigma tu. So sigma equal to force divided by area. Okay, but as usual you must calculate the area first, but you nak kan cross section of this cylinder. You just have to cut the cross section and then you akan dapat lah cross section dia bulat. Okay, jadi bila bulat, it's already written here, the diameter is 15 mm. So you can just use the formula of pi d square over 4, or if you opt to use pi r square. If I pi r square, then it become pi times 7.5 mm power of 2. Okay, then you will get the same value as the pi d square over 4. And then we just calculate the stress. Just put the 5 kilonewton as the force. So 5 kilonewton convert into newton, and you just divide with the area that you calculated. You will get 28.294. Simple sahaja. Then we go to question B. Calculate the amount of the shortening. Okay, so when it asks the amount of shortening, as usual, the formula FL divided by AE. So, sama juga 5 kilonewton tak payah convert when you use this formula. The length you have to convert because of the length of this cylinder before it's shortened, before any force put, the original length is 1.5 meter, jadi 1500 millimeter lah. And then the area, just take this the area here. Okay. And E also given in the question. Okay. The modulus of elasticity. Then you will get the value, which is 0.212 millimeter. Okay. Next, we are looking at example 15. So this example, if you see, there are the two forces acting at different direction, opposite direction. So as usual, macam yang saya ajar sebelum ni, kita kena bahagi dua like this. Okay. Calculate and determine the shaft amount of, the amount of shortening of the shaft and the elongation. Ayat balik. So maksudnya dia minta Whether it shorten ataupun dia elongate, maksudnya dia minta delta lah, which is the difference in length. So inilah saya dah bahagi dua, so dia jadi macam ni. So we have like one part and the second part. Okay, the first part kita ambil yang the first area because dia minta amount of shortening. So you going to use the formula of D equal to FL divide by AE, but dalam ni pun masih ada area lagi, so kita kena kira area lah because force kita dah ada. Length is 1500 ataupun 1.5 meter. Elasticity, modulus of elasticity also should be given in the question, which is 200 kilonewton per millimeter square. Sama je for the first part and second part. Sama je modulus of elasticity value 200 kilonewton per mm square. So elasticity pun dah ada. Okay, the problem here we don't have the area, so we just calculate the area first. Okay, suka hati you pakai formula ni pun boleh. Because of kita dah tahu dia bulatan, macam mana you tahu dia punya cross section bulat, although dalam question not mention anything about the area, tak ada cakap eh, dia tak ada bagi tahu apa-apa, dia just bagi tahu shaft. Okay, because of kat sini dia bagi diameter, so when you saw that dia punya tu diameter, so you know that the cross section going to be in diameter ataupun dia cross section adalah bulatan lah. Okay, jadi you kira dan you dapat 78.54. Then after that we can simply calculate the delta or difference in difference in length. Using this formula again, FL divide by AE, masukkan saja 10 kilonewton that you saw here times 1500, which is the original length of that the first part of the shaft. And you just divide with the area 78.54 and times with the modulus of elasticity, then you will get the value. Okay, here because of dia minta whether you need to state whether it is elongation ataupun shorten. Okay, determine the shaft amount of shortening, and elongation, so whether it's elongate ataupun dia shorten. So because of the, based on the direction of the force, so you know this is elongation because of the tarik ke keluar, jadi dia elongate lah because of this is the force pulling out the shaft. And for the second part again, we need to calculate the area using the area for the second part, which is diameter dia 15 mm. Masukkan saja pakai formula ni pun boleh, and then you just have to calculate the delta FL divide by AE. Okay, and here you see that the force is 5 kilonewton. How did I get the 5 kilonewton? Because 15 minus dengan 10 because of the different direction. Kalau direction dia sama macam ni, dia pulling out juga, then you add together lah. If the direction is the opposite each other, then you minus, and then you just times with the length, which is 2000 mm for the second part. Tak perlu tambah this one because you tengah kira. Sebenarnya you tengah kira area, you tengah kira kat sini, but why I still masih lagi draw this part because of you are the force dekat you are the force yang dekat sini, so just to show you that this force also act, will act on the second part of the shaft. Okay. Therefore, use the length dia 2000 mm and divide with the area yang you dah kira for 15 mm diameter and times with the modulus of elasticity, and you will get the value. We have reached the end of this recorded video, so I stop dekat sini. I hope that you watch this first before we start with our tutorial class. Okay. So thank you so much everyone and have a good day. Bye.